M. There we are. Thank you so much. I know some of you can't see me over there, but this is where our microphone is. I'm going to invite you to hear a couple of announcements before we begin. First of all, if you have a cell phone, please turn it off or mute that cell phone. And as you're taking a moment to do that for us, you might, as we kind of go through the performance tonight, a few things to keep in mind for us, and especially on behalf of David di Fiore's performance, we would ask that if for any reason you need to leave to use the restroom or any other need that you have, please do not move while there is a piece of music being performed. Please wait until the end of the musical piece before you get up and go. We'd ask that you please do not use the back doors to come and go. Use this forward door right over here where you came in. Please just use that for leaving and entering. And then when you've gone, please wait. If you hear music playing, do not re-enter until the music has stopped. And then you can come back in for the next performance. We also ask that you please hold your applause until the very end of the series in music in the concert tonight. So we ask, hold your applause, and at the end, we'll have lots of time to do that. And then finally, at the end of the concert this evening, we invite you, if you feel comfortable, to join us in the parish hall, which when you came in, instead of coming left past the tables, you're now going to go on the other side of the tables and down the hallway to the parish hall. We ask that you maintain wearing your mask throughout the performance and when you're coming and going and when you go in for the reception. The only time to remove a mask is if you are in the reception and seated at a table where there will be coffee and other kinds of desserts, including bonbons. In keeping with the theme, yeah, I know, keeping with the theme, I would give that applause too. So otherwise than that. So if you just remember, please wait to the end of a musical piece to come and go. Please maintain silence during the time that you're in here. And after the first musical piece, you'll have David di Fiore come out and speak to you. So at this point, I would like to invite you to welcome Maestro David di Fiore to Trinity Episcopal Church. Maestro.
Well, good afternoon. It's a delight for me to be back here in the Everett area, and especially at Trinity Episcopal, which has become my kind of second home here. The first piece I played actually was written for two harpsichords in its first state, and then it was often played on two organs, if the cathedral had two organs. And these Spanish organs were very interesting because they had these what are called short-length resonators. The horizontal trumpets that you see on the Spanish organs are very powerful, even though you will see often many pipes in the case, but many of those pipes don't speak. So it's kind of an interesting configuration of these organs. But this arrangement I played was made by E. Power Biggs for the organ, one organ, rather than two organs. The next set of pieces I'm going to do are very interesting. I like to think of street musicians playing these back in the Renaissance time. With whatever instruments they had at hand, they got together out on the street and people were dancing, and I can see this very easily with these. They kind of improvise, you know, these wonderful tunes. So, enjoy. Thank you. The next piece, this Toccata Jazzica, is quite interesting. There's references in this piece to the Pink Panther, you'll hear in the pedal, and Sweet Gothique of Bouman. You will also hear that tema in the pedal. And the jazz idiom of the swing is also in this piece.
Thank you.
always chuckle with that piece, especially with the theme from the Toccata, the Sweet Gothic comes in. It's quite amusing. The next selection is called Mozart Changes. This is the D major sonata of Mozart, which the composer changes to a jazz idiom. Well, you'll hear. Actually, it's quite well written and very interesting.
Thank you.
Now the next piece, we have our French devices, we call them, on these organs. This is supposed to be a cannon, and it's actually, it kind of makes me laugh. It's supposed to be a call to war, but it's a far too happy a piece to have a call to war. So I wouldn't call it that. I would say it's just a lot of fun with this cannon effect. Later on, we'll hear the storm effect, and I'll explain that when we get to it.
Thank you.
You know, I imagine, I hope it's as much fun to listen to as it is to play. I told my audience last week in Austria, they were laughing, and I said, you know, it's just a fun program, so feel free to laugh, you know. This is we'll have a jam here, you know. Okay, this next piece hails to your British tradition in the Anglican Church, although you probably won't think so when you hear it. These are seafaring tunes from Britain, and it's absolutely delightful what Rawsthorne does with these, but he also quotes Bach and Vivaldi in this piece, and Vidor, and in the score he writes apologies to Bach, apologies to Vidor, apologies to Vivaldi. So you'll understand when you hear it. Queen Victoria will never be the same. the next composition is by my friend and colleague, Stanislav Shurin, who is lives in Slovakia, is a well-known artist throughout Europe. He's taken to composition, and it's kind of an interesting story. He's written three pieces I know, but two of them are in manuscript form, and I said, please, I want to play your music, and you can't read it. It's absolutely impossible to read his manuscript. So I'm trying to talk him into having somebody put it into a readable form, but this piece is in readable form. This is his modal prelude, a delightful bonbon.
Thank you.
So we're back to France, and this piece features the orage. The orage is the French word for a storm. And I played this in Orléans in the cathedral for the festival titled The Dance. It's really not a dance, but this organ has the orage, which is, it's a vent hole down on the bottom that you press with your foot, and it brings on all the pedal stops with the big reeds and 32 foots and all these, and it actually sounds like thunder in the cathedral. I have to kind of simulate that here because, you know, we don't have that kind of acoustic or these bigger reeds on this organ. But it's still very effective on most organs, and you can get the, it's perfect weather for the storm. Now put yourself in Orléans with 8 seconds of reverberation with that, and there you got it. Will-o'-the-wisp is a, I think we all know fireflies. This is the best description of this piece. And it's kind of cool because it never rests. It's like perpetual motion. never resting, and the fireflies going all around, and they never quite stop, and you can see them flickering in the night, and this is a perfect representation of that. Charles Ives is an interesting character. He's an insurance salesman, and my friend Elaine Smith, who was a piano teacher in the Edmonds district, she said when she heard this piece the first time, she said Ives had just paid his taxes when he wrote this. It's interesting on several levels. I would say my description is irreverent would be the word I would use. However, it's also acidic, irreverent, and very funny. And feel free to laugh. You'll hear My Country Tis of Thee in a rumba. And my cadenza at the end, I combined the Slovak national anthem in the soprano with My Country Tis of Thee in G minor in the pedal. So you'll hear that in a cadenza at the end.
Thank you.
this rainy day. I really appreciate you being here. Thank you.
Yeah.